welcome to your first music lesson. My name is Mr. Romhani and I'm head of music, and today we're going to be exploring drawing sound, listening to music, and then trying to create something, maybe something you can try at home. Okay, all you need for the first part is a piece of paper and a pen or a pencil. What I'd like you to do to begin with is take the paper and fold it in half, like so. And what you're going to do on the top half, you're going to draw what you hear happening in the music. There's only one rule, and that rule is to leave your pencil on the paper at all times. Remember, we're just going to draw on the top half of the sheet of paper. So drawing what you hear. If you think the music goes up, you might draw a line going up. If it comes down, you might draw it coming down. There's no right or wrong answer. You're just drawing what you're hearing, what you're listening to. And there is a difference between hearing music and listening to it. What we're doing is we're actively listening to the music. We're making a connection between what we're hearing and what we're actually thinking about in terms of interpreting the music. So we're actually listening to the music rather than just hearing it. Okay, let's give it a go. This is a piece by Brian Eno. What did you get? I ended up with this. So this is me interpreting the music that I heard. And you can see here that if I begin where my pencil started, I had some really long sounds without any changes, and then it went down and so on. So that's the first part that we're going to use. We're going to try this exercise again, but this time, when you listen to the music, I'd like you to draw shapes. So it could be a star, could be a circle, any shapes that you think match the music. Again, there's no right or wrong answer. What you need to do though, is draw it in the blank half that you haven't covered yet. So take your pencil and let's see how we get on. Again, this is by Brian Eno, and this piece is called Dust Shuffle. So I've got some kind of diamond figures, some little circles at the top, and I've got other sounds that I thought I could hear coming on in between. So this is my picture. I've got two parts. I've got the first part based on the first part of the piece I heard, and the second one on the second piece we heard by Brian Eno. And this is going to be my inspiration for the next part of the lesson. Now you can try this with any piece of music that you like. I always like to get something that I haven't really listened to before, and it just makes me listen to it even more intensely. So for the next part, you must hang on to this. You will need this for the next part of the lesson. Okay, so for the next part of the lesson, we're going to need a few more objects. And these can be anything that you like that you think might match the sounds in your second piece. Let's take the first part that we created, the one with the lines where we left our pencil on the paper. For this one, we just need our voice. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to follow the line, and where it shifts, the pitch of my voice will shift in the same way. And we're going to try and layer these two pieces of music on top of each other. So you might need a piece of technology to do this, maybe on your phone, if you've got iMovie or you've got some other app that allows you to layer two sounds at once. GarageBand works, where you can record sounds, anything that allows you to layer or multi-track two sounds. It can be done on simple technology. So the first one, if we take the lines and we recreate our voice pattern, it's going to sound something, well, mine will sound something like this. So we're going to record a track of that, and when we've done that, we're going to layer that on top of our pictures. Now for the picture one, what you need are different instruments. So I thought, I've got little circles here, so I thought maybe the circles could be something like this, or something that's going to be short. So I've got an old tin plate, and I'm just going to tap that for my circles. So that would be that sound. I've got then this sound here, which are diamond shapes, and I thought for that one, because there's four sides of the diamond, I might go. Something like that for the diamond shape. I've got a bigger shape here, which is more, I think, a bassy sound, so I might go. Something like that. And my last one, or my second to last one, I've got another oblong shape here. That one might be this one. Something quite unusual. And then the final one, I've got this crashing sound that I found, and it might be. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to record those sounds separately. I'll record the pieces separately and then layer them up to form a piece of music. Here's what mine will sound like. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed that piece of music. It's really about exploring sound, finding inspiration, and thinking of a way in which we can organize sound. The first question, or one of the first questions that I ask you in Year 7 music is, what is music? What is music? So if you think about that, what have we just tried to do? Well, we've got different rhythms, we've got different pitch, we've got different instruments or different sounds. All of that is music. But all we're doing is organizing our ideas. We began with some inspiration. We organized, we came up with a starting point. We organized those onto different sounds, different rhythms, different pitch. And then we combine them together with some form of structure, what we call the elements of music. So we've been exploring really the elements of music. The next stage that we're going to move on to in Year 7 is taking something like this, which is called a graphic score, and turning it into notation. How can we take some of our musical ideas today and write them down as standard musical notation? And we'll be exploring that in Year 7. Well, I hope you've enjoyed today's lesson. I hope that you're able to create something. And maybe if you can share it in some form when you come back in September, I'd love to hear what you've come up with. Really good to meet you, and look forward to seeing you all in September.